गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर फिजिक्स, दैट इज़ मैटर. दिस इज़ योर फर्स्ट चैप्टर. सो बिफोर गोइंग इन टू डिटेल्स, वी विल लर्न दैट व्हाट इज़ मैटर, देयर कॉम्पोजिशन, व्हाट इज़ द कॉम्पोजिशन ऑफ मैटर, व्हाट एग्जैक्टली मैटर इज, देयर डिफरेंट स्टेट्स, देयर डिफरेंशिएशन, देयर मॉलिक्यूलर कॉम्बिनेशन एंड ऑल ऑफ दिस इन दिस लेसन. एंड दिस चैप्टर विल कम्प्लीट इन जस्ट ओनली वन लेसन. क्लियर? सो बिफोर गोइंग इन टू डिटेल्स, नाउ व्हाट इज मैटर, व्हाट इज मैटर. मैटर इज एनीथिंग दैट ऑक्युपाइज स्पेस. मैटर इज समथिंग और मैटर इज एनीथिंग दैट ऑक्युपाइज स्पेस एंड हैज मास. सो देयर आर टू कंडीशंस टू बी अ मैटर. वन इज इट हैज स्पेस, इट हैज स्पेस बट और इट ऑक्युपाइज स्पेस और इट हैज अ डेफिनेट मास. एनीथिंग दैट हैज डेफिनेट मास and occupies some space. So two conditions: one, it occupies space, and number two, it has a definite mass. That can be your matter. And also, matter is something that can be perceived by our senses, by smell, touch, or you can say sight, taste. Clear? So these are the condition of matter. So what is the definition? The definition will be anything that occupies space, anything that occupies space and has mass is called matter. Anything that occupies space and has mass is called matter. Clear? It can be perceived by our senses. It can be perceived by our senses of touch, number one, sight, smell, taste, and etc. So this is called matter. What is the example? Example, suppose example is air is a matter, or table. Table has space, it occupies space and has mass. Air is also occupies space and has mass. Or you can say ice, matter, or milk. So these are the matters, these are the examples of matter. Clear? Now what is the composition of matter? What is the composition of matter? What actually matter composed of? What is its composition? Now the composition of matter, that means it is composed of very large number of tiny particles. Matter is actually composed of very large number of tiny particles. Clear? These are known as atoms. These are known as atoms. So matter is basically composed of very large number of particles, large number of tiny particles. Those are termed as atoms. Those are termed as atoms. These are actually very tiny particle or very small particle. But it exists as large numbers. That means matter is composed of very large number of molecules, large number of tiny molecules. Those are termed as atoms. But this theory was later denied, or this theory was later rejected, because these atoms are so small, because these atoms are so small that it cannot exist freely in nature. Atoms are so small that it cannot exist freely as nature, or it cannot exist freely. That means it has no existence, it cannot exist independently. It cannot exist independently or it cannot exist freely in nature. That's why this theory was rejected. Clear? Later, John Dalton, a famous scientist, he proposed that actually matter composed of molecules. Actually, matter is composed of molecules, not atoms. Later, John Dalton proposed that actually matter is composed of molecules, not atoms. And this theory was accepted. This theory was accepted. So he proposed that actually matter composed of molecules, not atoms. And this theory was accepted because molecules can exist freely in nature. Because molecules can exist freely in nature. Atoms cannot exist freely in nature, or atoms don't have their independent existence. Clear? But molecules can exist freely in nature. It has its own existence. That's why this theory was accepted. Clear? So actually, matter is composed of molecules, not atoms. Clear? Now, what is molecules? What is molecules? Molecule is actually the combination of atoms. Molecule is actually the combination of atoms. Clear? It is made up of one or more than one atoms of same kind or of different kinds. Molecules are made up of more than one atoms of the same kind or different kind. That means it is the combination of atoms. Clear? So what is the definition of molecules? It is made up of one or more than one kind. It is made up of one or more than one atoms. It is made up of one or more than one atoms of the same kind, of the same kind, or of different kinds. So molecules are the actually combination of atoms. It is made up of one or more than one atoms of the same kind or different kind. Now, what is the meaning of same kind and different kind? Now, hydrogen, this is the formula of hydrogen. Oxygen, this is the formula of oxygen. Carbon, this is the formula of carbon. Now, these are all atoms, because these are all atoms. Clear? But if we say write the formula of molecule of hydrogen, the formula will be H2. Write the formula, molecular formula of oxygen, the formula of O2. Write the molecular formula of carbon, the formula will be C4. Clear? So these are molecules. Why? Because this is the combination of more than one atoms of the same kind or of different kind. So these are molecules. These can exist freely in nature. These are atoms. This is not the combination. These are atoms. These cannot exist as freely in nature. That means if we say hydrogen, hydrogen will exist as H2, not H. Oxygen will exist as O2, not O. Carbon will exist as C4, not C. That's why the theory was rejected. And John Dalton's theory was accepted, because molecules will exist freely in nature. Clear? So, same kind means the combining atoms in molecules would be of the same kind. That means these are the same kind. That means hydrogen H2 means HH. There are two atoms, hydrogen. Oxygen means OO. Two same kind of atom. C4. That means C, C, C and C. Same kind of atoms. That means here the combination of same kind of atoms. And the different kind of atoms means, suppose different kind of atom. Suppose NH3. This is a molecule. The molecule is termed as ammonia. This is your ammonia. Clear? Here different kind of atoms are present. One atom is your nitrogen and the three atoms of hydrogen. That means different kind. Clear? Suppose another molecule is your H2O, water. This is water. Clear? Here two hydrogen atom and one oxygen atom. That means different kind of atom. So the combination may be different kind of atoms or same kind of atoms, and that will be termed as your molecule. So if question is asked that write the composition of matter, we will write matter is composed of molecules, not atoms. Clear? Because that theory was rejected previously, and later John Dalton proposed that matter is composed of molecules, because molecules can exist freely in nature, and this theory was finally accepted. So we will write matter is composed of molecules, not atoms. Clear? Next, these atoms and molecules, both these atoms and molecules, both are very tiny or very small. Atoms are very small. Clear? Between these atoms and molecules, atoms are very, very small. But if we consider these two, that is atoms and molecules, both of these are very small, so that we cannot see them in our naked eye. We cannot see them in our naked eye. To see atoms or molecules, microscope is required. Microscope is required, and the microscope is compound microscope. The microscope that required is compound microscope, because this microscope is very powerful. Clear? There are three kind of microscope actually. One is your simple microscope, number two is your compound microscope, and number three is your electronic microscope. Now electronic microscope is very costly. Electronic microscope is used actually in research purpose. So electron microscopy is very costly, that is not available for normal purpose. Normal purpose, two microscopes are available. One is your simple microscope, another one is compound microscope. Now these molecules, atoms and molecules, are so small that it cannot see, you cannot see with your naked eye, and you cannot see with your with the simple microscope. If these cannot be seen with simple microscope, these can be seen only with a compound microscope. These are very very small, clear? So now we will see different kind of molecules. Now molecules are of molecules are of three types. There are three kind of molecules. One is your monoatomic molecule. Monoatomic molecule means it is composed of only one atom. That is your monoatomic molecule. Number two is your diatomic. Diatomic means composition of two atoms. There are two atoms present. That means diatomic molecule. And number three is your polyatomic molecule. Polyatomic means more than two atoms present. This is your polyatomic molecule. Now what is the example? Monoatomic molecule means there is only one atom. One atom means it can be argon. Example is argon. The formula of argon is Ar. Next, neon. The formula of neon is neon. Now only one atom is present, that is monoatomic. Diatomic means there are two atoms, that means hydrogen H2, oxygen O2, there are two atoms, clear? So these are diatomic, and more than two atoms, that would be your polyatomic. Polyatomic means, for example, water. These are polyatomic. Polyatomic means more than two. There are three atoms. One is your oxygen and two is hydrogen. That means total three atoms. That means more than two. So this is your polyatomic molecule. So molecules are of your three types. One is monoatomic, one is diatomic, and the another one is your polyatomic. Clear? Next. Next we will see the different characteristics of matter. What is the characteristics or property of matter? These are the characteristics or property of matter. So next topic is characteristics or properties of matter. So number one property is that matter is very small in size. Very small. They are very small in size. Clear? So number one property is they are very small in size. This is the number one characteristic. Number two is they have spaces between them. That means matter is composed of molecules and they have spaces between the molecules. Matter is composed of molecules, clear? That means molecules have spaces in between them. That means there is a definite space between the molecules of matter. So they have, number two property is they have spaces between them. They have spaces between them. Number three property is they are in constant random motion. That means the molecules, that means the matter is composed of molecules, and molecules are in random motion. That means molecules are not fixed. In matter, molecules are not fixed. They are in random motion. That means they can move freely. Clear? They can move freely. They are in random motion. They are not fixed at any position. So number three property is they are in constant random motion. Number four is they always attract each other. That means molecules always attract each other like magnet. They attract each other and they repel each other also. Magnet, when north pole and south pole, they will attract each other, and the same pole, that means north north and south south, will repel each other. But in case of molecules, that means in matter, molecules always attract each other. Clear? So number four property will be they attract each other. So these are some characteristics or properties of matter. Clear? So I will explain each characteristics one by one. So number one characteristic is they are very small in size. Suppose this is a container. Suppose this is a container and you are the container is filled with water. The container is filled with water. Now water is a matter, we know. Clear? So if we see the molecules of water in microscope, we will see that water molecules are of this size. Water molecules are of this size. Water molecules are of this size. That means they are very small in size. This can be seen with only a highly powered microscope, that means compound microscope. We cannot see this in naked eye or even with a simple microscope, because matter is very, very small in size. Clear? That's why this cannot be seen with your naked eye. That means this is the molecules of water. This is the molecules of water and these are very small in size. Clear? So number one property. Number two, they have spaces between them. That means molecules have spaces in between them. Now look at these molecules and these molecules. They have certain space in between them. Now this molecule, they also have certain space. This molecule, certain space. This molecule, certain space. That means the molecules will not be collide with each other. They will not collide with each other. They have certain fixed spaces in between them. Clear? Number three, they are in constant random motion. Now each molecule will not be fixed. Each molecule is not fixed in their position. They are in constant random motion. Random motion means the motion is termed as zigzag motion. They have the motion, this constant random motion. This motion has a fixed, this motion has not fixed path. The motion will be random. That means the direction will not be fixed. And this motion is termed as zigzag motion or zigzag path. This motion is termed as zigzag motion or zigzag path. Clear? The motion will be like this. Suppose this is a molecule, so it will move here. Again, it will move, it can move here. Again, it can move here, here and here. Like, they don't have any fixed direction. The molecules can move anyway, anywhere. The direction is not fixed. Clear? This motion is termed as your zigzag motion or zigzag path. Clear? That means particles are not at rest. Particles are not at rest. They will move randomly in all the possible directions. They will move randomly in all the possible directions and the motion will be termed as zigzag motion or zigzag path. Clear? Next four, they always attract each other. That means the molecules will always attract each other. That means one molecule will always attract to the other molecule. In this way, all the molecules will be attracted towards each other. Clear? So these are the characteristics of molecule. Now, just recall the property number two. Property number two says they have spaces between them. That means the molecules have spaces between them. And this space has a fixed name, particular name, and this space is termed as intermolecular space. This space is termed as intermolecular space. This space is termed as intermolecular space. So this was your container, and this is the liquid molecules, water molecules. So this space, the space between the two molecules, this space is termed as your intermolecular space. The space between the two molecules is termed as your intermolecular space. Clear? And this intermolecular space are different for the different matter. Clear? Now number four property, they always attract each other. Attract each other means the two molecules will always attract each other. That means this molecule will attract this molecule. In turn, this molecule will attract this molecule. This molecule will attract this molecule. In this way, all the molecules are attracted towards each other by a force of attraction. All the molecules will be attracted towards each other with a certain force of attraction. That means a force of attraction will be there between the two molecules by which they will be attracted towards each other. And the force of attraction will be termed as intermolecular force of attraction. The force of attraction by which two molecules are attracted towards each other is termed as intermolecular force of attraction. So the force of attraction will be termed as intermolecular force of attraction. Intermolecular force of attraction. The force of attraction by which the two molecules will be attracted towards each other is known as your intermolecular force of attraction. Clear? Now, if the space is larger, if the space is larger or if the space is large, between the two molecules, the intermolecular force of attraction will be less. Listen carefully. If the intermolecular space, that means the space between the two atoms, is large, then intermolecular force of attraction will be less. And if the intermolecular space is less, then the intermolecular force of attraction will be strong. Clear? Next, so if we sum up all these characteristics of matter, we will see that matter is actually made up of molecules. Matter is actually made up of molecules which are very small in size. Matter is made up of molecules which are very small in size. The molecules are in constant random motion. And they exert a force of attraction among each other. They have intermolecular spaces in between them, and the force of attraction will be termed as intermolecular force of attraction. I am repeating again. So if we sum up all these things, all the characteristics of matter, we will have that molecules is actually made up of molecules. Matter is made up of actually molecules which are very small in size. The molecules are in constant random motion, that means they are not fixed, and they exert a force of attraction among each other. They have intermolecular spaces and they exert a force of attraction which is known as intermolecular force of attraction. So this is actually matter, their characteristics. Now we will study the different states of matter. There are three states of matter actually, different states of matter. Now there are all total three states of matter. Number one is your solid, number two is your liquid, and number three is your gas. There are three states: solid, liquid, and gas. Clear? For example, like water, if you take water, it has three state. One is your solid state, that means ice. Number two is your liquid state, that means water itself. And number three is your gaseous state, that means vapor state, or you can say steam. So water, there are three states of water. One is your ice, that means solid state. Number two is your water itself, that means liquid state. And number three is your vapor or steam, that means gaseous state. So there are all total three states of matter, and now we will study each the property of each state, that means property of solid, property of liquid, property of gas. Clear? So number one, solid. Number one is your solid. So number one property of solid is intermolecular space is negligible. The intermolecular space in solid is negligible. That means in solid molecules, in solid, the molecules are very close to each other. Suppose this is a container, and in this container you have taken ice. That means the solid form of water, you have taken ice. So these are the ice cubes. So this is solid. The intermolecular space between these two is very small, very, very small. So small that it can be negligible. That means intermolecular space in solid is very small, so that it can be negligible. So number one property is the intermolecular space is very small and it is negligible. So this is the number one property. Intermolecular space is negligible. Number two is intermolecular force of attraction is strong. As the intermolecular space is very less or intermolecular space is negligible, that means the two molecules will attract strongly towards each other. If the intermolecular space is less, the attraction will be strong. If the intermolecular space is more, the attraction will be weak. Clear? As the intermolecular space is negligible or small, the force of attraction will be strong. That means the second property is the intermolecular force of attraction is strong. इंटर मॉलिक्यूलर फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इज स्ट्रॉन्ग. नंबर थ्री प्रॉपर्टी इज मॉलिक्यूल्स आर वेरी टाइटली बाउंड. नाउ व्हाई मॉलिक्यूल्स आर वेरी टाइटली बाउंड? बिकॉज इंटरमोलिक्यूलर फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इज स्ट्रॉन्ग. एज द फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इज स्ट्रॉन्ग, देयरफॉर द टू मॉलिक्यूल्स विल स्ट्रांगली बाइंड टुवर्ड्स ईच अदर. एज द फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन द मॉलिक्यूल इज स्ट्रॉन्ग, द टू मॉलिक्यूल्स विल बाइंड स्ट्रांगली टुवर्ड्स ईच अदर बिकॉज द फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इज वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग. इफ द फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन वॉज वीक, देन द टू मॉलिक्यूल्स आर लूजली बाउंड. Clear? As intermolecular force of attraction is strong, the two molecules or all the molecules in solid are very tightly bound towards each other. So therefore the number three property will be molecules are more tightly bound. Number three property, molecules are very tightly bound. Number four property is molecules are not free to move. The property of matter says that molecules are in constant random motion. We have seen in the characteristics of matter that there was a property of matter that molecules in a matter can be a random motion. That means they are in constant random motion, and this motion in case of solid are not so freely, because the molecules have strong force of attraction. That means the molecule will be attracted towards each other very strongly, and for this reason they are actually not free to move. They cannot move freely because molecules are very tightly bound, or the force of attraction between the molecule is very very strong. That means they are not free to move. Clear? They are tightly bound in that place. They will be tightly bound in their place. They will not free to move because the force of attraction is so strong in case of solid. Clear? So number four property is your that molecules are not free to move. Molecules are not free to move. Number five property is your molecules are very closely packed. Molecules are very closely packed because number four property is your molecules are number five property is molecules are very closely packed. Why molecules are very closely packed? Because the intermolecular space is negligible. The intermolecular space, that means the space between the two molecules, is negligible. That means the molecules are very close to each other. This is the reason that molecules are very closely packed in case of solid. Number six property, solids have definite shape and definite size. Why solids have definite shape and definite size? Because in solid the molecules are very closely packed. That means all the molecules are very close to each other. The molecules are not far away from each other. The molecules are very closely close to each other. This is the reason the solids have definite shape and definite size, because you can recollect all the solid molecules in one place. Because the solid molecules have intermolecular space is very less. That's why the solids have definite shape and definite size. Next, solids cannot flow. Solid cannot flow from one place to another. If we consider liquid, for example, water. Water can flow from one place to another place. If we consider gas also can flow one place to another place. But whenever we come to solid cannot flow from one place to another place, because the molecules of solid are very tightly bound. Because the intermolecular force of attraction in solid molecule is very strong. That's why the molecules are very tightly bound. They are not free to move. This is the reason that solid cannot flow. That means the molecules of solid cannot flow from one place to another place. Number eight property, solids cannot be compressed. You can compress gas, you can compress liquid, but you can compress solid. Solids cannot be compressed. And number nine property is they are very rigid. That means solids are very tough. You cannot easily break any solid, but solids are very very rigid. So these are the property of solid. Total there are nine property of solid. Now नेक्स्ट इज योर मॉलिक्यूलर मॉडल. नेक्स्ट इज योर मॉलिक्यूलर मॉडल. मॉलिक्यूलर मॉडल ऑफ सॉलिड. मॉलिक्यूलर मॉडल ऑफ सॉलिड. सपोज दिस इज अ कंटेनर. सपोज दिस इज अ कंटेनर एंड दिस इज द दीज आर द सम आइस क्यूब्स. दीज आर सम आइस क्यूब्स इन सॉलिड फॉर्म. क्लियर. सो क्लियरली यू कैन सी द मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ सॉलिड. दैट मीन्स द आइस क्यूब्स आर वेरी क्लोज टू ईच अदर. आइस क्यूब्स आर वेरी क्लोज टू ईच अदर. क्लियर. देयर इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस इज वेरी लेस. ऑल्सो एज द इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस इज वेरी लेस ऑल द आइस क्यूब्स विल अट्रैक्ट वेरी स्ट्रांगली टुवर्ड्स ईच अदर. क्लियर. दे आर नॉट फ्री. दे आर नॉट फ्री टू मूव. दीज आर नॉट द मॉलिक्यूल्स और द आइस क्यूब्स आर नॉट फ्री टू मूव बिकॉज द फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इज वेरी वेरी स्ट्रांग एंड द इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस इज नेग्लिजिबल एंड ऑल द मॉलिक्यूल्स विल वाइब्रेट इन देयर मेन पोजिशन. ऑल द मॉलिक्यूल्स विल वाइब्रेट इन देयर मेन पोजिशन. दैट मीन्स ऑल द मॉलिक्यूल्स विल स्टिक टू देयर प्लेस. ऑल द मॉलिक्यूल्स विल स्टिक टू देयर प्लेस एंड दे विल वाइब्रेट इन देयर प्लेस लाइक दिस. दे विल वाइब्रेट लाइक दिस. दैट मीन्स अप एंड डाउन. अप एंड डाउन. अप एंड डाउन. सो दिस अप एंड डाउन मोशन इज नोन एज टू एंड फ्रो मोशन. टू एंड फ्रो मोशन. दिस अप एंड डाउन मोशन और वाइब्रेशन मोशन हैज अ स्पेशल नेम. इट्स नेम इज टू एंड फ्रो मोशन. दैट मीन्स ऑल द मॉलिक्यूल्स विल स्टिक टू देयर प्लेस. दे विल नॉट मूव एंड दे विल वाइब्रेट इन देयर पोजिशन. एंड दिस पोजिशन दिस वाइब्रेशन और दिस मूवमेंट इज नाम्ड एज टू एंड फ्रो मोशन. इट इज एक्चुअली द अप एंड डाउन मूवमेंट. सो दिस इज द मॉलिक्यूलर मॉडल ऑफ सॉलिड. नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट ईयर इज लिक्विड. नेक्स्ट इज लिक्विड. सो द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ लिक्विड इज जस्ट द रिवर्स ऑफ सॉलिड्स. दैट मीन्स सम प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ लिक्विड्स एंड सम प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ गैसेज आर जस्ट द रिवर्स ऑफ सॉलिड. क्लियर. सो नंबर वन प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ लिक्विड. इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस इज समवट ग्रेटर देन सॉलिड. दैट मीन्स इन केस ऑफ सॉलिड द इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस इज नेग्लिजिबल. इन केस ऑफ सॉलिड द इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस इज नेग्लिजिबल. बट इन केस ऑफ लिक्विड देर इज लिटिल इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस. इन केस ऑफ लिक्विड मॉलिक्यूल्स देर इज लिटिल इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस. दैट मीन्स द मॉलिक्यूल्स हैव सम स्पेसेस इन बिटवीन देम. इन केस ऑफ लिक्विड द मॉलिक्यूल्स हैव लिटिल स्पेस इन बिटवीन देम. बट इन केस ऑफ सॉलिड द इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस इज नेग्लिजिबल. दैट मीन्स इफ वी अरेंज द लिक्विड एंड सॉलिड मॉलिक्यूल्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस द इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस इज लेस इन केस ऑफ सॉलिड एंड इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस इज मोर इन केस ऑफ लिक्विड. क्लियर. दैट मीन्स इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस इज नेग्लिजिबल इन केस ऑफ सॉलिड मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड देयर इज सम इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस. दैट मीन्स द स्पेस बिटवीन द मॉलिक्यूल्स इन केस ऑफ लिक्विड्स. नंबर वन. नंबर टू इंटरमोलिकुलर फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन. इंटरमोलिकुलर फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इज वीक इन केस ऑफ लिक्विड्स. इंटरमोलिकुलर फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इज वीक इन केस ऑफ लिक्विड बिकॉज इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस इज देयर इज सम इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस बिटवीन द लिक्विड मॉलिक्यूल्स. देयर इज सम इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस इन लिक्विड मॉलिक्यूल्स. दिस इज द रीजन दैट इंटरमोलिकुलर फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इज वीक इन केस ऑफ लिक्विड मॉलिक्यूल. बट इन केस ऑफ सॉलिड मॉलिक्यूल्स द इंटरमोलिकुलर फोर्स इज स्ट्रांग. इन केस ऑफ सॉलिड मॉलिक्यूल्स द इंटरमोलिकुलर फोर्स इज स्ट्रांग बिकॉज द इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस वॉज नेग्लिजिबल. That's why the intermolecular force is strong. But whenever we come to liquid, as liquid have little intermolecular space, that's why the intermolecular force is weak in case of liquid molecules. Clear? Number three property, molecules are not very tightly bound. In case of liquid, the molecules are not very tightly bound. But in case of solid, the molecule was tightly bound because the force of attraction was strong in case of solid. That's why molecules are very tightly bound. But in case of liquid, the molecules are very loosely bound. They are not tightly bound because intramolecular force of attraction is weak. That is the reason. Number four property, molecules are free to move. In case of liquid, molecules are free to move because the intramolecular force is weak. The intramolecular force is weak. That's why molecules are free to move. Clear? Next, number six property, liquids have definite shape. Liquids do not have definite shape. Liquids do not have definite shape. Liquids do not have any definite shape, but they have definite volume. Liquids do not have definite shape, but they have definite volume. Liquids do not have definite shape, but they have definite volume. Because if we take liquid in a container, if we take liquid in a container, the liquid will take the shape of the container. If we take any liquid and put it in a container, the liquid will take the shape of the container. That means they don't have any definite shape, but they have definite volume. Clear? Next property, liquids can flow. Solids cannot flow, but liquids can flow, because the force of attraction is very weak in case of liquid molecules. That's why liquids can flow. Clear? And the last property is liquid can be compressed. Solids cannot be compressed, but liquid can be compressed, because the intermolecular force of attraction is weak in liquid molecules. This is the reason that liquids cannot, you can compress liquid. Liquid can be compressed. So these are the properties of liquids, just the reverse of the property of solids. So if we study the molecular model of liquid, suppose this is a container and you have taken water molecules. So to draw or to understand the molecular model of liquid, we should understand very well the property of liquids. So the property of liquid was the intermolecular space is little. There is some intermolecular space in case of liquid molecules. So the water, if this is the water molecule, so there is little intermolecular space between the water molecules. And also the intermolecular force of attraction is weak, because the space is, there is some space. This is the reason that intermolecular force of attraction is weak. And the molecules also, like solid, the molecules will vibrate to their mean position. That means the motion is your to and fro motion. But this motion will be weak in case of liquids. So this is the molecular model of your liquid. And also they have a definite volume. But they don't have definite shape. Clear? So this is the molecular model of your liquid. Next, the last state is gas. So what is the property of gas? The property of gas, that the first we come intermolecular space. Now intermolecular space in gas is very very, they have very intermolecular space, because in gas molecules all the molecules are very apart from each other. In gas or gaseous state, all the molecules are very apart from each other. That means they are in terms of intermolecular space, gases have the highest intermolecular space, because all the molecules of gases are very far away from each other. They are very far. The molecules of gases are very far from each other. That is, the intermolecular space in gases is very very highest. Clear? So if we arrange according to intermolecular space among solid, liquid and gases, the intermolecular space is least in case of solid, and the intermolecular space is highest in case of gases. Clear? And liquids, they have intermolecular space is between solid and gas. So if we consider in terms of intermolecular space, solids have the highest intermolecular, solids have the lowest intermolecular space, that means least intermolecular space, and gases have the highest intermolecular space. So if we arrange according to our descending order, so this is the order. This is the order in terms of intermolecular space. Solids have the least intermolecular space, then liquid, and then gas. This is the ascending order in terms of intermolecular space. Clear? Because gases have the highest intermolecular space and solids have the least intermolecular space. So this is the in terms of intermolecular space, solid, liquid and gas. Gas have the highest intermolecular space and solids have the least intermolecular space, and liquids are the just in between solid and gas. And if we consider according to intermolecular force of attraction, the order will be like this. Now, in case of intermolecular force of attraction, intermolecular force of attraction, the order will be just like this. This is the intermolecular force of attraction, because solids have the highest intermolecular force of attraction and gases will have the least intermolecular force of attraction. Solids will have the highest intermolecular force of attraction and gases will have the least intermolecular force of attraction, because solids have less intermolecular space. Solids have less intermolecular space. That's why the force of attraction in solid will be highest. And gases have highest intermolecular space. That's why in gas molecules, intermolecular force of attraction will be less. Clear? So this is the order in terms of intermolecular space and in terms of intermolecular force of attraction. So gases will have large intermolecular space. Actually, the intermolecular space is highest in case of gases. The molecules are very far away from each other. And number two, intermolecular force of attraction is therefore very, very weak as the space is large. Next, the gas molecules are very loosely bound because intermolecular force of attraction is very weak. Therefore, the gas molecules are very loosely bound. They are not free to move. Clear? Next property, the gas molecules are not closely packed. In case of solids, the molecules were very closely packed because intermolecular force of attraction was strong. But in case of gas molecules, they are not closely packed because intermolecular force of attraction was weak. Next, gases can flow like liquid. Gas molecules can flow. And the last property would be that gases have neither definite shape and neither definite volume. Gases have neither definite shape and neither definite volume. They don't have definite shape and definite volume in case of gases, and they can be compressed. Gases can be compressed. Solid cannot be compressed, but in case of liquid and gases, both can be compressed. So this was the property of gas. Now if we consider the molecular model, suppose you have taken a container, and in this container, this is filled with oxygen gas or any other gas. So in a microscopic view, this looks like gas molecules looks like this, because the intermolecular space is very high. Intermolecular space is highest in case of gases. So intermolecular space is very highest, and as the intermolecular space is highest, the intermolecular force of attraction will be very weak. Clear? And the molecules are free to move. That means the to and fro motion, that means the vibration, that means molecules are stick to their position and they will vibrate. The motion was termed as to and fro motion. That motion is not present in gas molecules because the molecules are very farther from each other. That means the force of attraction is very, very weak. That means the molecules can flow from here and there because there is no force of attraction to bind the molecule. The molecules can flow from everywhere. So there is no vibration or no to and fro motion in case of gas. Clear? So this is the molecular model of your gas or gaseous state. So we have covered all the three states of matter: solid state, liquid state, gaseous state, their properties, their molecular model. Now a very important question, that what is the difference between these states? Just read the book thoroughly and you will find your answers. The question is asked that write the difference between the three states of matter. So just write the properties of solid, write the properties of liquid and the properties of gases. That will be the difference between the three states. So number one, solid. Number two, liquid. And number three, gas. So what is the difference between solid and liquid and gas? Number one, in terms of intermolecular space. In terms of intermolecular space, the intermolecular space in solid is less. Actually least. The intermolecular space is least. You will write the intermolecular space is least between the two molecules. Intermolecular space is least between the two molecules. Clear? In case of liquid, the intermolecular space is not least. There is little intermolecular space. There is little intermolecular space in liquid. So we will write
लिटिल इंटरमोलिक्यूलर स्पेस बिटवीन the molecules, little intermolecular space between the molecules, and in case of gas the intermolecular space is highest. In case of gas the intermolecular space is highest between two molecules, between the two molecules. Number two, in terms of intermolecular force of attraction, intermolecular force of attraction is strong in case of solid. Intermolecular force of attraction is strong because the intermolecular space is least. That means intermolecular force of attraction is strong between the molecules. Between the molecules. And in case of liquid, the intermolecular force of attraction is weak than solid. In case of liquid, the intermolecular force of attraction is weaker or weak than solid. So you will write intermolecular force of attraction is weak. And in case of gas, intermolecular force of attraction is very, very weak. That means intermolecular force of attraction is actually less or least. Intermolecular force of attraction is least. Next difference is that solid cannot flow. Solid cannot flow, but liquid and gas both can flow. So you will write liquids can flow and also gases can flow. Next difference, solids have definite size and definite shape. Solids have definite size and definite shape. You will write solids have definite size and definite shape. Solids have definite size and definite shape. But in case of liquid, they have definite volume. They have definite volume, but they do not have definite shape. So you will write they have definite volume, but do not have definite shape. In case of gas, they don't have definite volume and they don't have definite shape. That means neither definite volume and nor definite shape. So in case of gas, you will write they have neither definite volume nor definite shape. So these are the some differences between solid and liquid and gas. There are many more differences. For example, solids are very rigid. The next difference will be your solids are very rigid. Liquids are not very rigid and gases are also not very rigid. So there are many properties. Just go through the book and you will find many properties or many differences between solid, liquid and gases. Clear? Next, change of state. Last topic from this chapter is change of state. That means interconversion of state. That means how can you convert solid from liquid, or how can you convert from gas from liquid. That means the interconversion of states, or simply change of state. That means if you want to convert solid into liquid. If you want to convert solid into liquid, the process will be known as melting. Melting, or another term is fusion. If you want to convert solid into liquid, the process will be known as melting or fusion. For example, you want to suppose you have an ice block and you want to convert the ice block into liquid. That means water. You are going to convert ice into water. That means ice is the solid form of water and water is the liquid form of water. What will you do? You will just melt. You will just melt the ice. You will take an ice cube. You will take an ice cube from your fridge and just put it on your table and the ice will automatically melt to water. So the process will be melting. So the process will be your melting or fusion. So and the process in which solid is converted into liquid at a particular temperature, the process is known as melting. What is the definition of melting or fusion? Listen carefully. The process by which you will convert solid into liquid at a particular temperature, the process is known as melting or fusion. Clear? In this process, heat is absorbed. Heat is absorbed. Heat is required to melt ice into water. Therefore, heat is absorbed. So the process by which you will convert solid into liquid at a particular temperature or at a fixed temperature, the process will be known as melting or fusion. Now, if you want to convert liquid into gas, the process will be known as boiling. Or it has another term, that is vaporization. If you want to convert liquid into gas, the process will be known as vaporization. For example, you have water in liquid form and you want to convert water into gaseous form, that means steam or vapor. This is the gaseous form of water. You have water and you want to convert the water into steam or vapor, that means the gas form. What will you do? You will just boil the water. You will just boil the water and the water gets converted to your gaseous form, that is steam or vapor form. In this process, heat is absorbed. Clear? So the process will be known as your boiling or vaporization. So what is the process? The process by which you will convert liquid into gas at a particular temperature or at a fixed temperature, the process will be known as boiling or vaporization. Clear? These two interconversion in the syllabus, the two interconversion you have, just solid to liquid and liquid to gas, and the process and what is the definition. This is the change of state. Now the two data, two information you will remember. The one information is melting point of ice. The melting point, MP, that is the melting point. Melting point of ice is 0 degree centigrade. Clear? And boiling point of water, that is BP. Boiling point of water, this is 100 degree centigrade. Clear? Just remember these two data. Melting point of ice, that is it is 0 degree centigrade, and boiling point, that is BP of water, is 100 degree centigrade. That means water boils at a temperature 100 degree centigrade and ice will melt at a temperature 0 degree centigrade. Clear? So your chapter is complete. This is the end of our session. The chapter is complete. Now just two or three questions from your exercise. Important questions. That number one question is, what do you mean by intermolecular spacing? Number one question, question number five. Question number five is, what do you mean by intermolecular spacing? Number five question, what do you mean by intermolecular spacing? So what is intermolecular spacing? The spacing between the two molecules. The spacing between the two molecules of matter is your intermolecular spacing. So you will write the spacing, your answer is the spacing between the two molecules of matter, the spacing between the two molecules of matter is known as intermolecular spacing. The spacing between the two molecules of matter is known as intermolecular spacing. Next, question number 20. Question number 20, fill in the blanks question. Question number 20 is given as question A. solid arrow, this is liquid, and in B arrow dash the arrow given the boiling, and this is gas. So the process of conversion from solid to liquid, the process is your melting, or you can write fusion. And boiling gas, that means this is your liquid. The boiling means converting from liquid phase to gaseous phase as a particular temperature. So this will be your liquid. So the remaining questions we will do, that is fill in the blanks, match the column, numerical short questions you will do in your copy, and you will check them all. Yeah. Thank you. The chapter is complete. Thank you.